As I was saying, I will leave my pavilion here so that people can combat it if they want. Of course, oh, we have two pavilions even. Okay, Bakunin's Megaradon usually gives us a lot of gold. So let's... What the hell is this? Why a lumber camp, man? Oh, of course, you need a lumber camp to make a transmitter. Okay, I understand. Okay, anyways, lumber camp being placed here. I mean, hopefully everybody knows that they have to make a lumber camp and shit. Yeah, okay, good, 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 good. Why houses? Why houses? You have pavilions! God damn it, comrade! Okay, I will not believe it. I will not say. and then I was saying, no, you're too good for this. And now look at this. Now you look at this. Okay, of course, pavilion is the same as houses, but they just take one square. So yeah, hello world! How are you? Disgusted because I'm the only one. I know. Also the worst because I'm the only one. Do not make a dog, please. Do not make a dog. Okay, amazing. Good. He's not making a dog. This is a builder for some reason. Yes, you are sub. Okay, anyways. I guess that now they should all have enough wood. Comrade, well, maybe this was not a bad idea after all, because there is a lot of wood to be taken. Apparently, there is not much stone in this map. Apparently, there is no... Where are you guys going? Where are you guys going? Are you going to make a town center here? Because that wouldn't be that bad, really. Oh, there we go! We have a first town center from Jesus! Oh my god! It's Jesus! Praise the Lord! Okay, we got Jesus! Right there. He's going to Jesus on us. I'm just kidding. Anyways, look at this. We have hills on the water. Okay, we have hills on the water, which means that something attacking from the top of this is going to have bonus advantage. So now we have people with their town centers, apparently. Hopefully everybody will start making the town centers now, yeah. I'm gonna wait for Camra to make another house. Why? Why? You need a town center, man! Or maybe Camra just... You know what? Maybe he's right. Maybe he can just advance to the next stage with this, and he's just going to use his wood. But maybe he has enough villagers, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 villagers. So we started with 12 villagers. And, okay, we started with 12 villagers. So he can take a lot of wood, a lot of food as well. And then he can make a town center and advance to the next stage. Apparently, that's his idea. Hopefully it's going to be good. It's going to work. And now let's introduce the players, because now we have people with a town center. Come on, man. Okay, yeah, we have people with a town center. So first, playing as the Teal Hands, we got Osanimal. Then, playing as the Red... where the hell are you? Red Bungles, we got Mr. Xanatos. Playing as the Yellow Chinese, we got Enzo. Playing as the Green Khmer, without wanting to make a town center, we've got Kamrat, who of course is Khmer, so he can do whatever he wants. Playing as the Purple Mongols, we got a Candy Cane, who we had seen before. And finally, playing as the Gray or Dark Chinese, we got Jesus? It's okay. I say that because he has an interrogation right there. So yeah, that's why I pronounce it like that. So now we can make, we should make houses. Probably one more is going to be enough, because you have two pavilions that only take one slot, or well, one square. One tile, and give you 5 population. So yeah, that is the advantage of the pavilions. Of course, these guys do not have as much. They have a little bit more HP than houses at the beginning, but oh no, they don't. Okay, fuck, they don't, because they're pavilions. Of course, what the hell was I thinking? God damn it! How can I be so blind? So now I think that there is not much food around. The only places I see everybody making farms now. Everybody's making farms, and well, gold is okay because you want to advance to the castle age. Because Xanatos now walling in this area, probably is going to wall here, or maybe he will not, and there's going to be a hole in the wall, just as every time. Probably walling onto this area and then wall here, and that's going to be fine. But Enzo, will you allow that to happen? Will you allow that? Maybe he will just wall here, and that's going to be it for him. I don't know, but somebody will have to take this place as well eventually. There is a lot of gold, as I said before. This map usually gives us a lot of gold, but not much stone. Now the rest can be pretty much random. But yeah, in the beginning, as always, it's going to be random. And that's what we are witnessing right now. As a witness, I pledge. Well, look at that. Look at this. There is a lot of deer in here. I didn't notice that. So do we have more food somewhere else? Look at this. There's a cow, a lonely cow. And yeah, there is not much really. Looks like it was the only one who got who got lucky was, who the hell was it? Was it Lorenzo? Okay, it was not. Oh, okay, it was Candy Cane, who is Mongols, of course. So these guys collect wood from hunting 40% faster, if I'm not mistaken, because it was changed. So now, Comrade, where the hell are you going, my friend? Where is your town center? Oh, now he made a town center, amazing stuff. He made a town center. So now he's going to just move away a little bit here to the other side, just explore a little bit, with, carrying a little bit of gold with him. And he might see that there is a dead body right there if he explored this area. And if he didn't, then he will see this as soon as he gets closed. Well, the line of sight is right here, obviously, so he cannot see this. But he's so close, man. Also, okay, this is the square that he can see. He will be able to see this villager. I'm so sure of it. He can see this villager. But he's going there to see what the hell we have. And now he will explore a little bit with his gold miner. That is not good. Maybe you should have made a barrack or something. Or just advance to the next stage and make a skull cover or something. I don't know. But you see, this is not that good because it's a village that could be gathering resources for you. Anyways, Candy Cane has been fun, but Conrad, what are you going to do? I have always, every time I play with Conrad, I haven't seen him playing Khmer, so of course he will wait, he's going to boom until the end of times, and then he will make a lot of elephants. At least that's what I think he's going to do. But now, where is your stable, man? Being Khmer, I don't think that... Market? You can advance right away, you know that. But I think that maybe one stable and a scout would be okay. Or maybe he wants the market to see what his allies have. Maybe that's it. Look at this guy is there. Did he find the cow? It found the cow! How did he find the cow? Incredible, I thought that this cow was going to be lonely forever. But it was not to be. Candy Cane is now in the village, being the second one to advance there. Of course, Cameron was the first one, as we already seen. And there is one blacksmith and a market, a stable, coming up as soon as possible. Of course, these Mongols scouts have the most HP in the game, even more than Franks even. We have two relics in here. 3, 4, 5. We have 5 relics, okay, good. But it's not that necessary when you have this much gold. Is there a hole in here? No, there is not a hole in there. Do we have holes in here? I cannot see, really, I cannot see. But we have a hole. Okay, we have a hole. Jesus has advanced to the village, and Enzo is on the village as well. One playing as the Chinese, and the other one playing as the Chinese as well. Okay, we have both Chinese in there. We got Chinese, Mongol, Khmer, Mongol, Huns, and I died as a Vietnamese. Well, it was a sad moment of the suicidal ages when it happened, or whatever. But yeah, it's okay, I guess. Candy Cane now gathering as much wood as he can. I think that maybe rebuilding your Lumen camp eventually would be a good idea. Not now, because now 50 wood or 100 wood even, it's not the same in the feudal age than in the post-imperial age. It's not the same. One of them is vital, and then the other one is like okay, I can just sell 100 wood, because why not? And I can sell them in huge quantities. Another relic on this side that I didn't notice. And Ozanimal is going to make a lot of farms. He playing as a Hunts. Okay, what is the great idea behind this? You want to advance to the next stage? Is that it? I think that... Okay, he wants to advance to the next stage. Where are his two Dark Age buildings? There are three right here. And Zanatos advanced to the Feudal Age right now, making it possible to create boats right now. War boats! War boats. This place is open, but... Oh no, it's not open! Nice! Zanatos already... he saw that. And looks like there is not a hole in his wall. For once, we have somebody with a completely closed base. Finally. Okay, look at this. There is a hole in his wall. Of course, there is a hole in the wall, as always. And it's on the most obvious place. Obvious place. He was here, he closed. He saw this, he closed. He saw this, he closed. But of course... Oh, okay, there we go. Now Zanatos now has one space in there. Hopefully he's not listening to the stream, because that will be stream sniping, and that's not allowed at all. That is an unfair advantage against everybody else. Anyways, Candy Cane, everybody is now on the feudal edge, except for Candy Cane, who is on the castle edge. So he will make a town center, he's going to boom his sass up, and then he's going to make a castle. With that castle, he's going to attack with Mangudai, that of course can kill Ballista Elephants really fast, and then we will see some rams as well, coming with them. With full speed, of course, doing rams They have a lot of everything. Jesus is now still taking food from this side, but he looks like he forgot to click on the auto receipt farm stuff. Or maybe he didn't have enough wood. Maybe he didn't have... That can also happen. A builder now onto this area, bro. What is he going to do? My question is also, this guy, why wall like this when you can wall completely? I do not... Okay, he walled. Is this a hole in the wall? Guys, is this a hole in the wall? Let's check that out. No, it's not this. Where is that graphics? Okay, good. Dark, because that looks even horrible. Apparently there is not a hole. Oh, there is a builder right here. Okay, that is okay, I guess. We have a builder right there, and okay, well, that is weird. I don't know if this is walled. Looks like it might be walled. It also looks like it's not walled. I have no idea how to say that. Anyways, onto this side, it's walled. It's going to be open soon by these villagers who are cutting wood and making that, what do you call that? That deforestation happen. Onto this side, this is almost walled for some reason. It's not fully walled. And onto this side, he's going to just complete this. He's walled here. Probably here as well, and that's going to be... Oh, look at this. Okay, he's going to go with stone walls, playing on the Chinese, of course. Chinese have a stronger stone wall than anybody else. In the Imperial Age, when they research Great Wall. Or is it not in the Imperial Age? It is on Castle Age even. Okay, now we have Wildcat Cowardy from Jesus. And he's going to just try to look for something. Where is his table? I didn't see that one. Okay, look at this. It is right here. He's making another stable even. And of course, Chinese, they're making another Scout Cowardy even. Whatever. I don't know what the hell is going on with my pronunciation today. Anyways, Enzo is on the first place of the score. He claimed, I'm not a pro, I'm a noob. And look at this guy, with these points, he's of the Castle Age, make an amazing economy. All the resources are being taken, he has wood, he has food, he has fish traps even, because why not? He has fish traps. We got Carrot as well in here. Of course, the stone wall is as strong as its weakest link, as I always say. And the weakest link is probably this barrack. Of course, 3 tiles to attack, 1500 HP. Yeah. Xanatos now is on the Castle Age. Amazing stuff. Everybody's advancing except Ozanimal and Kamrat. Well, look at this. Ozanimal now making an archer range. The question is, why? The answer is cavalry archers. I think that's going to be cavalry archers because Huns, of course, have a cheaper cavalry archers than any other ship. Or, well, cheaper. Just cheaper. I'm not going to venture out there and say, oh, they are better than anybody else. No, I'm just going to say that they are good. They are good. They are cheap and that's it. That's it. I'm skipping frames apparently. Well, you know what? It's good. At least I'm not dropping. I'm not dropping them. Dropping and popping. Well, anyways, onto this side, we got Sados now making another town center, and Kamrat has advanced to the Castle Age. So he's on the Castle Age right now, and the only person we need to advance to the next age is of course Ozanimal. Ozanimal is going to just take as much wood apparently as he can. From where is he taking this? My god, that is far away! Anyways, now we got Xanatos starting his attack onto Ozanimal. I think that just one Scout Cavalry could end all these three guys. Just one Scout Cavalry would be enough. To take this. Why do you... Okay, you can do whatever you want, but just one Scout Cavalry, man. You need one Scout Cavalry. No, this is the worst unit you could have made, spearmen and archers. Okay, Scout Cavalry, amazing. Scout Cavalry is going to completely beat this. Scout Cavalry, come on, let's go, Scout Cavalry. That is it. Just one Scout Cavalry. You don't need it. Is this guy microing? This guy is microing. But the title said no pro. Okay, look at this. I know Scout Cavalry, amazing. Scout Cavalry is the best thing he can do. He can also make some skirmishers, but Scout Cavalry is better in my opinion. At this moment in time. Look at this, amazing stuff. Onto this area, he's still creating some archers. No idea why. Skirmishers would be better. Skirmishers are better, man, because they have bonus attack against archers. Onto this side, looks like Xanatos is not going to keep. Oh no, he's going to keep attacking. Now he's sending two more crossbowmen onto this side. Even three. Look at this. He has three archer range. So this is the first attack that we can see, right? Because I do not see any other attack happening right now anywhere else. So yeah, this is the only kind of war we have. It looks like these guys are not going to go out. They're going to just stay here, get probably in a big group, and then attack. So now what Ozanimal needs to do is to concentrate on his economy, advance to the Castle Age, take a lot of stone, make a castle here, or make a lot of skirmishers. And in a lot of Scott Calvary's. I'm sorry for that burp, but it was necessary. It was totally necessary. You guys have to understand how necessary that was. It was a a lot of everything. Anyway, so to this side we we have a candy cane making fish traps, because of course it cannot be any other way. Mongols have the best bonus attack on fish traps. My god, what am I saying? They don't have anything, man! I think that even farms are better at this point! Why use this? Because probably it's better, it's safer. I don't know, there are so many reasons that I don't understand. There are so many things that I don't understand. Zaratos now making a castle up on this side, and looks like after taking, or after even making so many Scott Cavalry's, now the castle time for Osaliman has been hindered a little bit. So now he should stop making making Scott Cavalry, start making skirmishers. The reason why, because he was attacked. Oh, there we go! Light cavalry, let's go! Light cavalry and light skirmishers. Nice! He's the last one, but he made it there, so it's better late than never. On the side, Candy Cane is getting. Oh, look at this! And there I was saying, these guys are safer. Well, no, Jesus is going to start attacking everything on the side. And Fargalis are going to just finish this, whatever it is. That is a lot of wood taken away from Candy Cane. But does it really matter now that he's in the castle, is taking wood from every other place? It doesn't really. On to this side, we got 1 mil, of course. We got knights in here that are ready to attack somebody, and that somebody can, it should be Jesus. No, he's getting ready to attack Kamrat. No, he's just protecting this side. Okay. Where is this guy going? Where is this guy going? He cannot be attacking those animals. Come on, man. Unless he's friends with Xanatos. And then, well, that's the only thing that I can think of. Anyway, so to this side, I think that it's better to create a lot of skirmishers, man. Skirmishers have bonus attack against crossbowmen. Oh, look at this, one hit KO. Totally bad. One hit KO. Okay, cavalry archers are kind of fine, but I think that putting a ram in the front would be better, so that it takes this. Oh, this is going to be a massacre. This is going to be a horrible massacre. Spearmen are not good against anything that is not cavalry, unless it has any kind of bonus. But yeah, looks like a Candy Cane is coming all the way through the side to take on. Look at this. The player who is on the top of the score is taking on the player who's on the bottom of the score. How not good is that? It is bad! The poor Osaliman is going to be killed at this point. Unless he moves somewhere and tries to survive somewhere. But I don't know if that's going to happen really. On to his side, Jesus is still attacking this dog. Maybe he's going to get ready to attack Candy Cane, but Candy Cane doesn't care really, because if he cared, he could have sent everything to somewhere else, maybe to attack Jesus. But it looks like he doesn't care. He just doesn't care, and he's going to just use his galley, maybe put it here and attack some villagers, and that's it. Now it's time to look at the amount of gold that is there, and Candy Cane knows it. He's going to take as much as he can. Oh, look, knights. They are kind of okay, but they have no upgrades, so yeah. Skirmishers, man, where are you? Oh, there we go, we got lead skirmisher, but you need a lot of them. You need a lot of them, man. Oh my god, yeah, he can take 2 hits, but yeah, look at that. He made more damage with this than he made with the knight. Anyways, he needs to make a lot of skirmishers and put the flag inside this archery so that he can mass about 10 of them probably, and then just attack. And that's how he can survive that. On this area we have a Candy Cane. Still, yeah, he finally made it some center, and I'm being attacked. God damn it, I'm being attacked by Jesus. You could convert this pavilion, man, if you wanted to. You play as a Vietnamese. I think that they have redemption. And it looks like Jesus is going to attack Osaniman as well. What the hell did Osaniman do to you guys? What the hell did? Look at this. With these resources, with the food, with the gold for the knights, and all the things that this guy is using Osaniman, he could have made a lot of the skirmishers. And just 4 of them, or 5 of them, no, even 3 of them could have finished this. Now we need less skirmishers. No, man, don't make pikemen and cavalry archers. That is not good. Anyways, town center now in place onto this side to take a little bit more gold, of course. And looks like Jesus is actually attacking me from under the hill because he doesn't care really. That's how much he cares, guys. That's how much he thinks I am a threat. He doesn't think I am. Onto this side, Candy Cane. Now, okay, you made this to make farms around it. Give me logic, man. Give me logic. I need to understand stuff. Onto this area. Yeah, these guys have a lot of defense and everything, but this is not going to work. At this point, when you have this amount of crossbowmen, you make mangonels. But if you don't know how to use the mangonels, then you just move somewhere else and try to survive somewhere. Probably here would be a good place. Yeah, it looks cozy here, Osaniman. It looks nice there. Why not move there before dying to everything? Oh my god, this is going to be a disgrace. This is going to be a horrible disgrace. Yep, it was a disgrace, just as I said. And there are no upgrades on these guys. There is no anything, and he's sending them one by one, or well, two by two, but it's still not the same. Jesus has now advanced to the Imperial Age, being the first one to get there, and Osanimal thinks that he cannot take it anymore. It's not enough. I mean, it was enough. He cannot do anything else. And Xanatos has done what he needed to do, which is, of course, kill one person. Now, the next one is probably going to be Enzo, who is kind of... No, he's not protected, but he's okay. He's okay. So where is the next attack going to come from? Well, we have a Castellan to the side, probably with some Chukonus in there, because of course it can... I don't think there are petards playing on the Castellan, that's the only thing that you can do. Enzo is now in the Imperial Age, and it's time now, you're playing as a Chinese as well, against another Chinese player. Oh, Mongol! Oh, okay, he's playing as a Mongol. Okay, Mangudai. Okay, Mangudai. Okay, that is bad. That is bad, this guy's Mongol. And he's good in the game, apparently. Because he microed and everything, he knows, and he has made upgrades and everything. So I can tell that this guy is not a noob. Which means that when you add not a noob and Mongols, it's trouble. It's trouble for you. It's going to be a lot of trouble, man. Just get inside your town center now, because there is nothing that you can do, unless maybe placing a tower? I think there's nothing more than you can do. On the other side, even like that, there is a lot of gold everywhere, so there are going to be a lot of Mangudai coming everywhere. On the other side, do these guys have... Yeah, they have ballistics now. Okay, it's okay, it's hard, it's hard. It's gonna be really hard, but Enzo needs to attack this guy now. If he wants to have the Mongolian player dead, Kamrat needs to attack this guy as well, because he wants to have the Mongolian player dead. Enzo now coming here with some camel riders. Of course, Chinese have good camels and crossbowmen as well. What is the problem with that? I don't see a problem with this, actually. I think that this is actually a good counter to that Mongolian death bomb or whatever, or snowball even. Heavy camel riders right now, they have been upgraded, as you guys can see. They are shining, now they are Super Saiyan, and that is interesting. On the other side, we got Xanatos now advancing with his battering rams and with his Mangudai. Of course, Nomads should have been done already, so that he can delete all the houses that are inside his base. And have a little bit more space. Look at the amount of everything in here. Xanatos has advanced to the Imperial Age. Okay, now that's a problem, guys. That is a huge problem. This guy is going to build something, probably a castle here, and take down people as fast as possible. Xanatos attacking here with a lot of crossbowmen. Also, now Cozy Candy Cane is coming with some Elite Mangudai, but Candy Cane is being attacked by two people. Or he's going to be attacked by two people. Three people even, eventually. Enzo is on this side. We got Xanatos on this side. We have a Kamrat on this side. But Kamrat is going to be just peaceful until this is a good time to attack. Anyways, let's see if there is a hole in the wall in here. Apparently there is not a hole yet, but there must be somewhere. No, okay, we don't have a hole, but at some point it might happen. I see, or well, I saw a trebuchet. Okay, a trebuchet down to the side, taking this castle down, and these knights are going to go down easily, because camels have bonus attack against knights, of course. On the other side, it looks like all these resources are not going to be taken, because why would you when you have a lot of resources in your base? There is a lot of gold in here, a lot of gold in here, and a little bit more gold somewhere around here. Yeah, right there. That is a lot of gold, and that is the perfect map for Mongol players. However, on Bakulis Mega Random, we have seen that you either have a lot of wood or you don't have much at all. And this map looks like it's the one that doesn't give you a lot of wood. But okay. They just wait and see how it goes. Usar coming up to the side just to explore a little bit, and looks like Candy Cane is going to be killed because he doesn't have access to this area now. He's losing it. There is one castle about to go up here. Is that going to be a loud castle? It's not going to be a loud castle, but it's going to be a failed castle, because it's going to go up and then it's going to go down easily. You have one battery ram that soon is going to be a cap ram with drill and everything, and probably this mango is going to attack as well. And here, of course, Candy Cane can make some mango to take down these battery rams. That's going to be it. To the side, we have now Seedrops coming here to try to take a Candy Cane down. An attack coming from the south, an attack coming from the east. Well, no, from the north, even of his base, and even a monk that is giving a little bit of health to other people. Now, this castle will not go up, and if it goes up, it will go down easy. Look at the amount of trebuchets that are here. Yeah, they are all going to attack on this side. Meanwhile, Candy Cane is kind of protecting this side as well, so this is actually nice. He's defending against three people at the same time. Of course, one of them is Enzo, the other one is Jesus, and the last one is Mr. Xanatos. Of course, this Since Russia, we're just going to do a lot, really, because whatever that comes out from this side is going to be completely different than this Elite Mango deck. They are Elite Mango deck with almost everything upgraded in comparison to Candy. Well, Candy Cane has the same thing. It's almost fully upgraded. They just need Paladin Tactics, and everything's going to be completely just fine. We've got now Seasram's coming from here, from the Enzo, the Chinese player, and looks like Enzo is not having any problems with Xanatos. Can he have him? No, he can't, because they are allied. They are allied. How can they be allied? Of course, guys, you kind of need to. Of course, Khmer, guys, this is Khmer. Look at that. This is Khmer. This is Khmer, and all of these farms are fully, they are optimal. All of them are optimal. I think that maybe Khmer is going to get ready to make a wonder here. That would be amazing. But I don't know what is people going to do. Of course, I just hope that nobody has clicked has allied together against this guy, because if it is like that, then everyone will win together, and there's going to be a problem. That's going to be a huge problem. Of course, it's not going to be my fault, not because I didn't pick the, not because I picked the seeds. It's not going to be my fault, because they just decided to do that, knowing that it would happen. Of course, it's never my fault. I'm just trying to clean myself right now. Okay, castle now down. His workshop is never going to be completed, and this one is going to be killed by Mangudai. Mangudai, guys. Mangudai with almost full upgrades. Did this guy already make Paladin Tactics? Let's check that out. Paladin Tactics. Plus 1, plus 2, okay? Yeah, plus 1, plus 2, but I think that Mongols are only missing no Paladin Tactics, right? No Paladin Tactics. Okay, now they have Paladin Tactics. Okay, now I see them. Okay, now I see them. Okay, anyways, Trebuchet down. Looks like Candy Cane has actually made it to survival. On this side, we got Kamrat, also with two houses onto this area, and Jesus. No, it's not Jesus. It is Candy Cane, who's the one who's taking a lot of gold, stone even, from this area. Jesus doesn't really care about any of that. I think that the only thing he cares right now is about booming. He has an army here. Yeah, he has an army. But yeah, he only cares about booming. And this place is kind of walled, I would say. Yeah, it's walled. It is walled. Right now, I can see that it is actually walled. Into this side, wall. Into this side, wall. No, it's open. It's open right here, man. And is Candy Cane going to do something with that? Look at that. Rule of the stream, if you don't have a wall in your base, you yourself will make one. And that is what we just had here. Candy Cane entering like Pepe in his house because Jesus didn't wall this. Now, is this castle going to kill these villagers? Oh, look at this. This guy actually noticed. Okay, now it's time to move a little bit. Run away, man, run away! Oh, is he going to micro his way out? No, he's not going to. Okay, it's good. It's done, it's done. Now you need to close this, man. You need to close this a little bit. Heavy Cavalry Riders now coming onto this area, and you should see that there are people crossing here, right? Right? No, you don't. Of course you don't. Well, we have a problem, Houston. We have a problem. We have a little bit of a problem, and it is that Candy Cane has Jesus has a hole in his walls, and now we have people here making stables, and Candy Cane has no idea of it, even though it's on plain sight of him. But Candy Cane, Jesus is actually is actually finishing Candy Cane. But we have this problem, that we're going to have a lot of Hussars coming into this guy's economy soon. Pretty soon. Because of only these two trees. So that's the problem we have right now. Okay, anyways, now what else? Okay, these guys are going to die to this castle. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And, okay, 4. That's it. Okay, now we have look at this, this guy didn't notice. How can you not notice, man? Okay, look at this, there are even guardians on this side, all this economy is going down the shooter, and yeah, he's also been attacked by Xanatos on this area. Now finally Jesus has noticed. Yeah, okay, this wall is going to be okay, I guess, these walls are going to get finished apparently, but it was a little bit late, man. You only needed to, yeah, okay, place a house in there while getting this place open. Yeah, that is not a good idea. Is there one tree in there? Yeah, there is a tree, so okay, it's fine. It's fine, we're fine with that. Onto this side, this is still open, man, this is still open. You need to realize that it is still open. And now we need one camel, just one or two camels in here, and that's going to be it. Probably just take everybody close to this castle, and it's going to be, okay, there we go. There we go. Now we have 2 or 3 camels, just like I asked, and that's going to be all. Now, Looks like Anakin is not going to be able to do anything else, because all his economy is now being raided. We have Elite Mangudai coming up onto his side, and this guy's taking food from so far away, but now they're moving onto this area. So, Conrad, what is it that you're doing here? A lot of houses. Why like this? Because he has style. That is the only reason why he's doing that. Twisted Enzo still on the first place of the score, and now he's pulling up a funny liquid. He's not going to attack anybody until it's the end, and then when the end happens, he's going to attack whoever is left, and that's what we will see. Jesus, now he's coming. Now has walled this area. He can explore a little bit more to the north if he wanted to. This place is open, but who cares, right? Right? Who cares? Just you don't have to wall it all to be safe. Anyways, looks like Candy Cane is going to lose now. The only stable that he had on to his side, and now yeah, it just went down. Apparently, yeah, I thought for a moment that somebody resigned, but no, it was not like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four villagers died, at least. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At least 5 villagers died, at least. Because some of them were killed while they were taking wood and stuff, or building the walls even. But this side is open, look, even the deer is going to just go to the other side of the walls. Man, that is horrible. When you have a hole in the wall, it is just a problem. And so now coming up into this area, he looks like he's not just going to be he's not going to be passive all the game, he's going to just keep attacking whatever he can. Well, he's going to just keep attacking, he's going to just attack. So we start Enzo with Heavy Kamen Riders, we've got also Xanatos coming here with Elite Mangudai. Close combat, should be friends with them, but look at this. All the Candy Cane units have died. Sorry Candy, says Enzo. I'm so sorry about it, but I had to do it. I had to do it. You denied me at the start of the game, says, and Candy Cane says, well then, Well, there's nothing I can say. Look at that. 1, 2, 3. And all is going to just go down. Everything. Everything. And now we have Jesus coming in here to try to take this Elite Mangudai down. It is a question every time. Hello! Malice! And look at this. It gets bigger and bigger. And all of them are fully functional. All of this is fully functional. It doesn't matter what you think, you might say, oh, this is stupid, but it's not, it's actually Khmer. So, yeah, it keeps growing and growing and growing. Now you need to delete these ones and go all the way to the back, and that is it. Okay, that title is a question, but it is a question that you need to answer in your life. Because, oh, look at this, Candy Cane now surviving in the most unlikely of places, right next to Jesus? It's getting close to Jesus? Oh lord. To his side, Enzo now getting inside his town center just to try to defend against whatever is close. And there we go. The attack of Enzo is going to be unstoppable. So, guys, I think that this guy is kind of a problem now. There's a hole in the wall, so maybe taking down his economy wouldn't be a bad idea, really. It's completely unprotected to his side. Maybe Enzo is going to pull a betrayal eventually, soon. Now, well, I don't know. To his side, we also have one dog. Why do we have a dog in here? Looks like Conrad is the one that is... no, it is not Conrad, it is Jesus, the one who's watching this. So probably there's going to be a transport ship, and the transport ship is going to go all the way to the other side, or maybe attack Conrad like this. Well, if you're trying to get to this side, I regret to inform you that it's not going to work. It's not going to work. We have a lot of stables right now, we have a lot of gold income. Where the hell is the gold income with this guy? Well, he should have a lot of gold income to make a lot of... elephants. So yeah, he's just trying to survive. And looks like, yeah, the trample ship happened. Now it's time to delete the trample ship, or I don't know. You decide if we shall leave. What? If he shall leave. Who? Who's going to decide that? Okay, he's going to go through this area, and there's nothing right there, but he's going to watch this farmland right there. And it's like, and it's going to be like, he can leave, says the camera. So yeah, okay. That is okay, I guess. But he's going into Enzo's base without knowing that. And inside Enzo's base is going to be probably around here. Now Candy Cane is going to see this and let's see his reaction. Let's read his reaction once he sees this. Is he even going to say something? Because he's concentrated on this. There are a lot of mangoes to his side that nobody know that exists for some reason. Nobody is just exploring everything. I don't know why, guys. You should kind of explore right there. On to this side, we have Oh my god, the lead man with a killing a lot of heavy camel riders. Everything is going down. Everything is being completely destroyed onto the side. Jesus sending now cavalry that are not going to do anything against this Mangudai. You're playing as the Chinese, so maybe Lichukonu would be a good idea. Maybe Lichukonu would be okay. Okay, now we have another docking here, and probably we will have one transport ship again. One, of course, that was here, somewhere around here, right? It was right somewhere around here. Yeah, okay, okay. No, it wasn't here. Come on, man. I really want to see where the hell was it? Where the hell was that? My god, did I miss it so far? Okay, it was here. It was deleted. Okay. Now transport ship onto this side, and then probably a town center here. And then so we'll have no idea of what's lurking behind this back. We also have a lot of elite battle elephants into this area, and all of them are going to go into the battle. I don't know, are you going to attack Enzo? Are you going to attack Candy Cane? Well, Candy Cane is here and he's surviving. He's doing really well, despite of him being attacked. Dude, why? You're Chinese! I know you are. Oh, look at this! Oh! Oh, it was a nice explosion. It was not as best as it could have been, but it was okay. It was okay. We need a lot more of that, a lot more of that, and not all of them died, but okay, it's kind of fine, I guess. To this side, now looks like Candy Cane has managed to get to the other side. He's now free! Or at least that's what he thinks. Where is your town center going to be? Because I know that you have one here, and this is not going to be your first economy, but probably this is some kind of decoy to make people think that after they kill whatever is here, you will be dead. But that is not going to be the case. Stelatos now, Trebuchets. Coming up in here for some reason that I do not understand. Oh, there we go. Do not. You need. Okay, now. Well, okay. No. Never mind. Never mind. It's never a good time. Now it's a good time. Well, now it's not a good time. This is so situational, man. This is so situational. Yeah, there are a lot of farms on this side, and we have also a little bit of elephants and a lot of scorpions. How do you deal with that? Enzo is playing as a Chinese. If you don't make a lot of... Well, he has better scorpions, right? Yeah, this guy shoot twice, but this guy have a better anti-pierce. So, yeah, it should be okay. Yeah, there's going to be a gate in here just to prevent this guy from advancing. And we have another town center coming up here from Candy Cane. We have everything that Jesus had in here being destroyed slowly but surely. And I don't think that heavy camel riders and cavaliers are the best option right now. Really, I don't think so. I think that the best option right now is Chukonus. Chukonus. It could be skirmishes as well, but Chukonus. I don't think this is going to work. Oh, look at this. Now this guy's taking down the trebuchet. I don't think all of them are going to be taken down. Maybe one more and that's it. Okay, it didn't go down. Well, it survived with 2 HP, 7 HP even, amazing. And now, looks like Conrad is going to start his attack eventually, or well, soon, against Enzo. Of course, Enzo can see all of that, and he playing as a Chinese. What do you do against this? Scorpions and probably... Scorpions and Mangoles probably. Yeah, a lot of Voyagers. A lot of Voyagers could take these Scorpions down, and then you could just attack this with your Chukonus, but I don't know how that's going to work. Enzo says, no, do not do that, do not even think about it. But yeah, there's going to be one transport ship coming up onto this side, eventually, it's going to happen, the transport ship is going to happen. But is it going to gather somebody from this town center? We have no idea. We will keep you informed as the news advances. On this side, Jesus is losing a castle, is losing economy, is losing camels that he's still making for some reason. He's making camels to fight against Elite Mangudai. I know that they have bonus attack against Mangudai, but that's if they can reach. And I do not see them reaching at all. Also, where is the transport ship? We need a transport ship at least to be here and to kind of pretend that everything is going to be fine, right? Yeah, we can have a transport ship right there. Do we have a transport ship here? No, it was deleted. Okay, it is. I guess that's it for that base. Well, it's a decoy base as I said before, so that's what we have. As we said, heavy camel riders. Just where are they going? You could attack this economy. You know, every time I have said this until the, I don't know how many times I said this, but when a Mongolian player does stuff like this, they usually have their whole economy unprotected. Their whole economy. So if you take down. These farmers, well, farmers are not good. If you can take down these gold miners, and probably the ones that are somewhere around here, that's going to be it. Just you need to take this guy away from wood, away from gold, and that's going to be it. That's how you kill a Mongol player. Because the only thing that he's going to do is siege and Mangudai. Both of them cost wood and gold, so yeah, that's what you do. Onto this side, I thought that this was a wall. Sadly, it is not a wall. It is just a lot of people going, coming and going. Why do we have that? No idea. But okay, 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 okay. Onto this side, Xanatos is still killing everything that Jesus has. For some dude, why make? I'm going to eat one Roskia because I cannot just watch this and watch it with a straight face. Hmm. God damn it. That was a bad idea. Or about something. I don't know. Okay, I've been attacked! Well, I was being attacked. Look at the everything, man. I know Chanitza are not one of the best candles, but god damn it, they are not going to last against Mangulai. Unless you probably put some skirmishers behind, I guess. But this is the wrong unit composition. Okay, now you're making all the skirmishers. Now you start to making them. Yeah, that's what you should have done a long time ago, man. That what you should have done a long time ago. Now we have a stable sub to this area for some reason. Looks like Enzo is going to let this guy live for now. For now. Just for now. Is there a market here, by the way? No, there's not. But Enzo, I'm coming back to his base, apparently. Because he's getting ready for an attack from Comrade QB. So, what do we have now? Yeah, okay, finally you're making... finally you're making elite skirmishers, which is okay. Elite skirmishers are good, but now this guy's probably going to make rams or cavalry or something like that. So you need to think about it as well. Tell me the teams. Did we hear a bomber tower? Yeah, we did. Okay, there we go, bomber towers. Do they have ballistics? Yeah, they do. No, they don't. Okay, fuck. No ballistics for Jesus? And why is that? I have no idea. But yeah, what is ballistics, man? If you don't have a, do you even have a university? What is that? Yeah, he... No, he doesn't. Does he? Yeah, he does, because there's chemistry right there. Now, this is a huge loss for Xanatos. This is a huge loss. Or even a good trade for Jesus? It's going to be a good trade for him. Because he was attacking from the top of the hill, apparently. And he killed a lot of units that cost gold, and he just used wood and gold. Well, no, you don't need to send them like this, man. Make a group of them and then kill them all. And then kill them all. And to the side, now we have Candy Cane attacking with all these plants, but we have heavy camera riders on the side that are going to completely kill these guys. Unless they get onto a checkpoint. That way, they can do something. Yeah, they will do something. Look at this, Candy Cane is actually coming back. Because of course, he can come back with all this economy right here. And also an economy right here that nobody has noticed. How often do you see cavalry killing heavy camera riders? You don't, because it shouldn't happen. But now it is happening. And we are going to just watch it with a sad face in our face. With a sad face in our faces, yeah, in our heads. What? That is redundant. It was kind of says me what? I cannot read what you said or what people said even. I cannot read that. 11. I don't meet everyone but you. Oh, you mean comrade? Yeah, maybe they're allies. Yeah, I don't meet everyone but you. No, we are friends. We can be friends forever, man. And I will be only yours. That's what he might say. Anyways, to this side we got a comrade now getting ready with his heavy scorpions that shoot twice with a lot of bomber cannons that are going to just completely demolish them. So I think, yeah, there is, how do you defend when you have this? Just make a lot of onagers and chukonus. I think that's going to be the answer. I think that's going to be the answer. I think I'm not saying that it is, I'm saying that I think it is. Anyways, don't tell me that this is a line of villagers. Please do not tell me that this is a line of, it is a line of villagers. Oh my god. It is a line of villagers. Oh, now we have elite chukonus coming finally! But we need. Yeah, chukonus are going to be good against this. Maybe some elite skirmisher will be a good addition to the mix. Yeah, that is actually good. That is actually good. You are helping purple, Sesenso. You are helping purple! They are allied, so I guess it's okay. What's so bad about that, says Candy Cane? Well, it's bad because this guy can die, right? Yellow's being aggressive towards me, says Camera QB. Is he? And you see a lot of warriors being placed onto the side. That's the only thing that I can see. But the Xanatos advancing now with his elite mango lane, somebody should make a wonder eventually. Not Xanatos though, because he has everything on his favor. Maybe Enzo, maybe Kamrad. Yeah, it could be Kamrad. Just imagine if Kamrad made a wonder in here and then he walled all this side. Just imagine, that would be amazing. It would be a problem for everybody else, but it would be amazing for us to see. So now, oh yeah, Chocolus now coming, only six of them for some reason. Dude, do not send them in small groups, man. And especially not when... Well, okay, he's going to take down the Trebuchet probably. Oh my god, he didn't even do that. Oh no, that is bad. Okay, now Town Center's going down. Jesus, he's going to be completely killed, apparently. He didn't even finish his gold onto the starting of the map. On his starting base. And he's not refreshing his lumber camp. My god, that is bad. On to his side, what do we have? We got Candy Cane with a little bit more units and one camera that is ready to attack. Ready to attack Enzo. Okay, he attacked Enzo, but not from this side. He attacked from behind. Okay then. Alrighty then. Instead of going for the economy, he's going to take down all the military first. It kind of makes sense. So this guy cannot produce more units. So yeah, he must have thought about. Oh my god, that was bad. Must have thought about it. To his side, what else do we have? Okay, this castle is going to go down in with the next shot. And there we go, it's over. It's over, man, it's over. Now take down this archer range, taking down this siege workshop, stables, you name it. It's going to go down, everything's going to go down. And now Enzo will have to counterattack. So, how do you counterattack that if you want to go for the economy? Well, why not make a wonder? I really want to see a wonder. Anyways, this is a good army composition. It's a gold intensive army composition, but it's a good army composition. On to this side, we got Xanatos still advancing, trying to look a little bit more of Jesus. On to this side, do we finally have ballistics? No, we don't. God damn it. Why don't we have ballistics, man? Why don't we have ballistics? God damn it. Why don't we have ballistics? Why? You have a university right here, a perfectly good university. Ballistics only gold and wood. You have gold, you have wood. So. Man, does he not have wood? Yeah, he does! Then why? Sorry, Gray, it's a Candy Cane. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, man. I am sorry. But that is a kind of a game, because Jesus said sorry, Purple, at some point. And he said he put a sad face. I think that's what I believe happened. Besides, Mangua is still attacking skirmishers. Well, I think that these guys could take these other guys now. Is this a scout cavalry? It is a scout cavalry. Why are they not fully upgraded when you... Okay, he's Chinese. So, are they friends now? Okay, it looks like Jesus and Xanatos are in good terms now, or are they not? This is Jesus, right? Yeah, he is. This is Xanatos, right? Yeah, he is. Okay, they are in good terms now. They are allied now. Why are they going to attack now? What are they going to attack now? Well, looks like it's going to be Kamrad, because Enzo is kind of a problem. Yeah, we have a monk right here that can convert one elephant, but when you have all these elephants, you need more monks, man. You need a little bit more monks. A lot more monks, even. Now it's time to escape, man. Where are you going to run away? We have a castle now coming up, and I think that Enzo, Kamrad taking down the houses, is going to make this guy go pop-blocked. Pop-blocked! Now we have elite battle elephants. Well, they are kind of fast, so they can reach this onager. Will they reach these ones though? We have a lot of hunters here that are going to die to the own to the attack of these onagers even. And to this area, look at this. This is basically unstoppable. You cannot stop this right away unless you convert everything. But I don't know how you're going to do that. Really, I have no idea how you're going to do it if you plan on doing that as well. So what else? We got Candy Cane here with some. We are another town center. Maybe he forgot about that. Maybe did he? No, I don't think he did, because they are all. Did they build this and then they stopped? I don't know what the hell just happened. And so now making another town center here, probably for farms. I think that's a farm town center and castle. It went up some seconds ago and now it's gone. And whatever that is close is going to be killed as well. Look at how fast these guys go down. Not only the one in the front, but also the one in the back. And that is totally bad. Candy Cane now coming in here. And it would have been good to finish this guy when it was time to do so. But now it's a little bit too late. It is too late. And what are you going to do now? You just have to just sit there and take it. There is nothing. Take it in your face, because there is no way that you can stop now Candy Cane, who was also attacking Jesus. And Jesus has decided to make an alliance with Candy Cane. We got Enzo here completely losing it all. Xanatos with his completely defenseless economy. It doesn't have any look at that. It doesn't have any kind of defense, but well, that's how he wants to live. He wants to live his life with adrenaline. If he gets attacked, then the adrenaline is gonna rush to his head, and that's what he likes, apparently. Enzo taking gold on his side. He has some other bases, so yeah, it's going to be fine. Maybe somebody could ally everybody and then use spite. I think that wouldn't be that bad. Well, I don't know. That is good juice. Everything now that is a whole seer is going to burn them to the ground. It is impressive. These guys just attack with their whatever this is, and then they put things on fire. And then in order to stop the fire, you need to use a hammer. Because historical accuracy. Candy Cane now coming back, playing Mongol against Mongol. And well, Xanatos has a partisan tactic, so this guy should win. In theory. Making 6 units against Mongol is totally not advisable. Totally not advisable. Of course. Now what do we see? We got one Candy Cane now going. Where's the gathering point of this? Where the hell is the gathering point? It's right here! Hello! Shimon! Join the party! Welcome, Shimon! But yeah, let's just continue with that. Now we have Xanatos being completely destroyed by Candy Cane. Well, that is kind of a problem. Now, what do we do, Candy Cane? What do we do? Do you, by the way, Jesus, do you finally have Elistix? What the fuck is that title? It is a title. It is a question. It is a perfectly understandable question. Come on, guys. Don't make so much of a fuss about it. It's just a normal, innocent, infantile question. There's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing bad with it. It's just a normal question. Xanatos says, fuck! Man, I've been attacked in my base and I don't have any defenses in there! Of course it's understandable, man. It's completely understandable. Come on, man. Have you really been far even as decided to use even go one to look more like? Come on, man. Just type yes or no. What the hell is this? Well, the fish cannot go out now. Maybe it can build a... No, it cannot build anything there. Candy Cane says GG! I don't think that it's GG for you, really. Maybe it's GG for somebody else, but who? Gonna take care of maintenance. Emergency, please. Of car maintenance. Oh, okay. Emergency peace. Okay then. I can't move, says Enzo. I can't move! I just made it in here, and I shipwrecked. God damn it. Well, that is the best fishing ship. If you die, if you kill this guy, it's going to just go deep inside the earth. Of course, it's going to... How do you say that? Deep? Kinder? I don't know, I don't remember the word. Man, I remember the word, but once I see... I don't remember the word, but once I see it on some translator stuff, I will remember it right away. It's going to drown! Drown! Yeah, it's probably that's the word. It's going to drown inside the earth. But now, as I was saying, if you take down this economy, then that's it. That's it. Now Xanatos needs to go back all the way back to come to his base to try to defend it. That happens when you don't have any kind of defensive here. That is a problem. So, in theory, this elite bangle, they should kill these elite bangle elephants. Not because they are stronger, but because they are faster, so they can move and attack. Move. And there we have it. Now we got Camera QP that is not going to get closer to attack with all at the same time, but he's going to... Oh my god, I don't know how good is that, really. But okay, he's going to use... he's going to try it. So now we have a battle between elite bangle and a lot of heavy scorpions, but these heavy scorpions are not attacking all the... Oh, look at that. Now they are all attacking at the same time. Okay, then. And a lot of mangle guys are dying. It's something that I was... Well, how do you explain that? There is a lot of scorpions taking down Mango Day. What the hell, man? And this economy is now just like this. It's gone. It's gone now. It is gone. And it was just what I said at the beginning. You don't need to kill this army. You don't need to take down this house, this castle and trebuchets. No, what you need is to take down its economy. And this is exactly what Conrad did. And now, what we have? We have a dead Xanatos. On to his side, looks like Enzo is coming back for life. Double shots are mean. They are mean indeed. But yeah, Conrad, you have to be careful with Conrad, because if you let him go to the post-imperial age, then this happens. Then this happens. And also this happens. And this is not something you want to mess with, really. A stampede of everything is not good for your health. It's not good for anything, really. But for now, Xanatos... Oh, god damn it, Conrad, what the hell is wrong with you, man? You could have killed Candy Cane. You didn't. And now, look at what happened. He could have killed Enzo. He didn't. And now look what's going to happen. He could have killed Xanatos. But now he's going to rebuild. And look what happens. Man, that is not good. That is not good. Or maybe he thinks that... okay, now he says this. Okay. Okay, I guess this is fine, but all these heavy coppers are going to completely destroy these halberdiers. I think that the best answer to this would be onagers. Onagers and maybe some monks behind, I don't know. His prediction is onagers and probably some chukonus to defend these in the battle elephants. Probably that would be it. Okay, now where are we going, man? We need to... Oh my god, the lasers! The lasers! Okay, it's gone. They are all gone. And to his side, this is what Enzo has. This is the only thing that Enzo has apart from this. He has another economy. So yeah, if you let these guys live, they're going to come back for revenge. And it's not going to be fun for you, man. Do we have a market in here? Yes, we have a market. Do we need trade? No, we don't. Not yet, at least. Not yet. Please don't tell me that you're starting trade. Because you have a lot of gold income from this side, so it's going to be completely fine. You're fine, man. To his side, barracks now. Being taken down one by one. All these houses. All these beautifully built houses are going down. All of this. Look at this guy. It looked like a snake about to. How do you say this? Choke its prey. Yeah, that's what I was trying to say. To this side, we have all these Pomarcanos. Just imagine if for some reason a lot of mango that you decided to go through here and just look what's good. Well, that would be bad. Oh, so we have Enzo, Camra, and Xanatos not friends. Okay then. The Chocolus, I think that they can be good against the mango. Let's just wait and see how it goes. They have less HP. They have less range. Oh, well, the same range, but less HP. But they can shoot... 3 or 4 times at the same time. So, oh my god, if these onagers get the shots, then that's going to be bad for all these chukonus. All of them might die in one shot. All of them might die in one shot. They will not, though. They will not. So, it's okay. It's good. But they might! They might eventually. What map is this? Says Shimon! It is Bakunets Mega Random. Because, of course, there is not much wood. There is a lot of gold and it's completely random. So, it's Bakunets Mega Random. Now, it's time to kill Mr. Xanatos. Xanatos is about to lose his Lumberjacks in here, and it looks like Enzo actually betrayed the guy. Now a lot of these guys are going to die. And who was it? It was Jesus, the one who didn't have a ballistics. For reasons unknown, goddammit, that was close! Are you going to really try to take down this Ornager with your Elite Chukonus? It's not advisable. It's not advisable like this. Not like this, man! Okay. He's losing the onagers. How? Is he losing the onagers? Okay, he's going to lose the trebuchets right now. And now it's time to take down all these little mangolites. But to this area, we still have more onagers being created. And I think that this battle is going to be won by Xanatos, really. Well, that is kind of a problem. That is not good. We have a lot of elite mangolites. Of course, you cannot do anything about it right now. But a comrade should be able to... Okay, he can see all this, and now he's going to completely clean it. And the only thing that Enzo will have is this. That's the only thing that he will have. What map is this? Those areas seem slow, not real. Yeah, they have not real. Why? No idea, man. Have no idea. But Xanatos is going to do the way he wants to do it. He will want to win this game the way he wants to win it. He took over 1 hour to research a partial tactic. But look at this. He's still winning it. He's still killing everybody. So there's something that he must be doing right, right? So now, really is no longer meta. It's no longer meta. Now we have a lot, 3 castles creating Chukonus non-stop, and it's time to kill Xanatos, really. That's the only thing he has. There is one bit of farmer here, and that's basically it. Xanatos can survive with this if he makes a town center somewhere around here. Maybe he will be able to do so. Maybe, I don't know. And onto this area, Enzo still has a lot of villagers, and now the problem are these onagers. So how do you deal with those onagers? With onagers of your own, probably. So now it's time to just make some... Siege workshops and do something about it. Come on, man, you can do something about it. Where are these guys going, though, is the question. They are coming in here to get a little meeting. And to the side, we got Jesus attacking these elite battle elephants. Of course, they're going to die kind of fast. And now it's time to take down whatever that comes close. Of course, now we have a battle between the Chinese heavy scorpions that have more pierce damage. And we got heavy scorpions from Khmer who can shoot twice. So, who's going to win? Of course, the one who has the most units. That is how you answer that question. On to this side, Electroconus is still being created. I think that maybe putting some elite skirmishers in the back instead of Chukonus, that would be a nice combination so that you can lose your skirmishers to these units and use elite Chukonus the way you intend them to be used or whatever. So now look at the amount, look at this castle. Now it's time to take down on these elephants. So how are these scorpions going to do against the elephants? Looks like they do really good, or partially good, or they do good. Yeah, okay, they are fine. Okay, the ballista elephants all died. Now it's time to run away with your siege rams and time to kill everything that is on your side of the desire. However, we can see that Xanatos is trying to survive as best as he can. Two castles, three siege workshops, some houses in there, and probably one villager that's going to do something else. I don't know what. Okay, he's going to take a little bit of wood. And now, Enzo is coming all the way back to his old base because it's not being taken by Kamrat for some reason. He's letting everybody everybody do whatever they want. And now the battle is going to be between Kamrat and Jesus. And now, we have this open space. I don't think that we will have a wonder with Xanatos. Okay, they say. So what are they talking about? No idea. But it must be something good. Okay, goodbye. Oh my god, that was bad. And now you have to lose the rest of them. Because why would you want them once you have lost a lot?
And now it's time to do some more. Man! This is not good! Maybe using some trebuchets to attack these guys from far away would be a good idea. Maybe attacking from far away would be better. Kamrat down the top of the score. Taking down on Jesus. And we have a lot of incoming riders here. Will they try to take down the same scorpions? Well, that is a question. A question that we need answers. That we need answered even. Now we got a scorpion against scorpion. First siege, counter siege. And look at this. When Kamrat Cube is just looking at some other place, all his scorpions are going to just be killed in the meantime. We have a lot of heavy coming riders. Why is this guy so insistent with heavy? Well, now they make sense, but why is he insisting so much with heavy coming riders? I have no idea, man. He has been making nothing but heavy camera riders during all the game. All the game, only heavy camera riders. That's the only thing that he has been making. On to his side, is this trade? No, it was not trade. Okay, good. Take down the traps. It's because it's going to be kind of easy to take them down. Getting a little bit, getting closer would be good. Okay, another castle coming up here for Enzo. Enzo going to try to survive the best he can. There is one house in there, there is a little bit of gold in here, and I don't think that Enzo has any more. Oh my god, he has villagers right there. He has villagers. What is he going to do with them? Maybe make a monastery, take this relic with you. That wouldn't be that bad. Now what? We still have this trebuchet taking down castles, and for one castle that goes down, another one gets selected. But in the end, the stone is still going to come back, so yeah, we have that problem. And to his side, there are even more battle elephants coming here to fight against Jesus. And the battle is kind of a stalemate right now. Of course, Kamrat QP has more range with the scorpion because Teach Engineers and bonus, and team bonus, and that's how you do that. Now, where are these guys going? What are you guys going to build? Tell me, it would be interesting to see what are you guys going to build. Well, it looks like they were going to build a stable, but now they're going to build a bomber tower without ballistics! Without ballistics, yeah, of course, it's not going to have ballistics. Wall it, please, so that you can it can last a little bit longer. Now we still have this battle between Chukonus and Elite Mangulai. Yeah, there are a lot of Elite Mangulais here, but I really think that eventually Enzo might win this. The reason for that is because I see less and less and less Mangulais each time. I did not see the same amount before. That were at least two groups that were there, more than one group. Yeah, more than one group was there, so yeah. I think that Jesus, no, well, Enzo might take this one. He might. Well, let's just wait and see. I'm going to open my door because it's a little bit hot in here. It's too hot even. Okay, it's good now. I'm sorry for all the pulses that I'm getting, but I haven't taken my breakfast. And I'm sure not taking a lunch now. Because it's now time for the lunch, but I'm taking it. Anyways, come on, man. Why so many heavy camera riders? I just do not understand. Why do they love so much? I know Chinese have good camera riders, but god damn it. It's not like they are going to save you for every time. They are not good for all situations. They are good for most situations, but not all of them. This is not one of those situations. As I said before, Enzo will eventually take this. The reason being, of course, that these guys are not. They were a lot before, but now there are not so many. Into this area, now we have Camera QP advancing. And he's going to take down these stables, of course. So, what do we do against this? As I said before, Jesus used to make a lot of warriors and a lot of chukunus. That's how you take it down. You take down the bomber cannons, you take down the heavy scorpion, but you need to kind of micro. Imagine a bomber tower! Imagine a demolition in here! Imagine a demolition shot in here! It would be amazing, but I don't know if Jesus is going to think about that. Anyway, wrong strat save, it's a Shimon! God damn it, Shimon, okay. A 200 swordsman, probably. Brute force it with 200 swordsman would be a better answer. Of course! Shimon, I answered correctly. I answered correctly, I'm sorry, Shimon. I'm sorry. Sorry, I failed you, man. I was trying to give advice, but you were the one to give me advice. Anyways, there are a lot of heavy scorpions with the most unlikely of counters, like cavalry. How did this work? No idea, but it actually worked. It worked. It didn't work in the sense that kick killed everything, but it worked economically. Because that is worth a lot more than a lot of heavy light cavalry. That is worth a lot more. Now, what is that? This is economy. My god, he's gone. And do we still have this wall? No. Where are these guys? Where did this guy go? Okay, now it's time to completely kill everything. This is a little bit of revenge from Enzo onto Zarados, who can now not enter. God damn it, why so many heavy camera riders? Why so many of this is like watching Shimon go with 200 swordsmen to everything. This guy is just full heavy camera riders. It doesn't matter what they throw at him. Heavy camera is going to be the only thing he's going to do. That's the only thing. Of course, now the battle elephants here, I do not see any demolition ship. It would be amazing to see some, but no, I don't. And that is kind of a problem. To this side, we have Enzo still advancing, taking down the stone center, while the stone center also attacks with 8 arrows, as you can see right here. And now that I open my door, we have a fly here. God damn it, we have a fly. And I do not like flies. Still, we have a lumberjack in there, you're chilling, completely chilling. And to this area, this town center, it looks like it's not going to go down. But these Mangolai are going to go down. They are going to go down. Okay, they're moving a little bit now, but okay, it's fine. And to this area, Red needs Hussar to tank, says Flex Factor. Yes, I agree with you. Hussar to take down the Lit Skirmishers, yeah. And maybe some warriors, because he just made like 5 warriors and they all produced a lot of results. Enzo just was on the back foot on this one, and he managed to get back from it. Look at that. Interesting. On this side, this castle is going to go down. It's going to go down. And this is everything that Zarados will have. As I said from the beginning of the game, you just need to take this guy's economy and then that's it. And look at this. Kamrat did that and now look at this guy. He doesn't have an economy. He's trying to run away for his life, for his dear life. Trying to come back to his old base without knowing that there's nothing here, really. And so he's going to be completely fine. I usually would put towers or houses in here to see if somebody's trying to come back. Plus not letting people space to build. But okay, some guys just don't want to do that. Some guys just want to clean it all and then just leave. Not me though. Not me, but that's me. Thanatos says, phew! As he runs away, Thanatos said, with a sad voice, or for, with a relief voice even. Two decisive swords have been taken down, so now where are the 200 swordsmen? I do not see them. Sad stuff. On to this side, we have a lot of heavy scorpions coming, and somebody, maybe Xanatos could make a wonder now. Maybe, because that is still an option. Ezra is the one who is on the back foot right now. So, keep playing as the Chinese, he's going to build something else right there. Lord, better than Khmer Farm, says Xanatos. What do you mean? What do you mean better than Khmer Farm? There we go! There we go! But why here? You can wait for Capture Age for the... Oh, I can't, man. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be... I will be able to read the chat, hopefully. Ezo says, I have to go. God damn it, why? Everybody needs to go. Candy Cane had to go. Now Enzo needs to go. God damn it. Let me finish. I'ma let you finish. But Kamrat had the best wonder of all times. Of all times. Now you can finish. And I'll leave. Yeah, of course, Enzo. Yeah, of course. He's going to go. Hopefully that's just on a strategy. So just imagine, guys, back in the medieval times, some king decides to make an army just to kill somebody. He says, I'm just building an army, man. I'm just training my people to be complete killers. But after they have been trained, I'm going to just resign as a king. And I'm going to just let you live. No, that's not. That's because wonders are cool. Well then, Kamrat doesn't think that wonders are cool. He's going to come and check what is protecting the wonder. And he will find that there is a lot of stuff here. So, Kamrat, do you think that this is just a wonder that is happening? No, it is not like that. I told you, let me finish. As I said before, Kamrat says, I'ma let you finish. But I had the best wonder win of all time. Actually, it was Meyer Pansy. It was Meyer Pansy, the one who had one of the best wonders I've ever seen in my life. And now, we have a market here. So, are you going to trade or something? No idea, but we have a town center here taking a lot. Oh my god, there is a lot of gold and a lot of wood coming, which means Mangulai is incoming as well. Mangulai, a lot of Mangulai. The wonder should have been here, probably. Or maybe here. I don't know. It should have been somewhere else. But this wonder is going to take forever to go up. Going to take forever. And it's also going to take forever to make it, to give Enzo the win. Now, Kamrat is still taking... Oh my god, Jesus, why? Why do you keep sending melee units? Why? Look at that. It doesn't matter. Oh, he took one. But does it really matter? He cannot even kill a Hussar. God, that is bad. So why not make up 5 onagers, then risk it all, send them here, and that's it. That's it. The scorpions and gold, and then you can send a lot of cavaliers in there. That's what you do. But no, you're making cavalry riders. You're making cavaliers. Cavaliers are the Chinese, because of course, cavaliers are the Chinese. Well, at least he can kill the guys that come here. At least that's something. At least that's something. And it looks to me that Kamrat is actually going for the wonder. It's close to him, so maybe he wants to go there. But now Jesus, he's kind of okay. His main economy hasn't been affected really, which is this one. He was attacked on this side. He was attacked on this side, but looks like Kamrat never noticed what was here. He just went all the way here and then he moved. He made a U-turn. So okay, now we have a lot of these guys moving. So okay, here they're going to take a little bit of gold. I think taking this stone would be a good idea as well. Maybe to sell it if you don't want to use it, because they are, this is kind of expensive, man. This is kind of expensive. So expensive. So now it's time to attack, man. It's time to attack. Stop and let them attack, or just use the attack button and whatever. Okay, goodbye elephant, goodbye everybody, and that's going to be it. This wonder is still not half done, man. It's going to take forever, and we have a lot of units protecting it. This wonder is not going to make it. It's not going to make it, but it's going to be a nice try. Anyways, it's going to be a nice try. So now, looks like Kamrat QP has been defeated on this side, but he's going to send even more units. Well, he was going to send more units onto... Okay, there we go. We have a lot of heavy scorpions, we got a lot of elite battle elephants, and where is he taking all that gold from, is the question. Where is that gold coming from? Well, he took a lot of gold at the beginning of the game. Now, does he have... Yeah, he has a little bit more gold, but I don't know how much will he last with that. Oh, he can take a little bit more in here as well. And yeah, that's going to be seen by Jesus, but okay, it's fine, I guess. On to his side, On the side, we still have all these heavy scorpions, all these elite battle elephants, and it looks like okay, we have sound, amazing. So now we have onagers. Yes, you can have your onagers and everything, but dude, you don't need to do it like that. You don't need to. Oh my god, these are for the scorpions, not for these elite battle elephants. And Enzo now has given 100 tribute to me. To me? Can you give tribute to people that is dead? Apparently, you can. To me? Oh, he's giving me everything that he has. Probably that's it. I don't know. I don't know what the hell he's trying to do, but okay, I guess. Thank you. Even though I'm dead. Yep, he gave me tribute. Why did he give me tribute? Because he steals men's soul and makes them your slaves. Perhaps. I don't know what is it. I don't remember how it goes. Okay. More heavy Kamen Riders, why not? Why not? More heavy Kamen Riders to take down on elephants and to take down on heavy scorpions, of course. You know what the worst thing is? Is that it's actually going to work, probably. This guy's actually made it here! How? Why? Why you should attack as soon as you get there? Why would you wait so much? Why would... Can you guys... you know, how you call that? This quarantine is taking a little bit of my life. Today I dreamed about going to the supermarket. God damn it, I dreamt about going to the supermarket. Imagine if scorpions ever got ballistics. Yeah, it would have been horrible, man. It would be kind of OP, I think. It would be OP. But it depends on the civilization. Maybe you can give ballistics to somebody, to some, I don't know, Turks? Maybe Turks? Because it's going to be hard to use them, they don't even have heavy scorpions. So yeah, maybe that would be. Good luck everyone, Sesenzo, and now he's going to die. If he dies, then this wonder is going to be destroyed. Camera says GG. Yeah, okay, are you going to destroy this, or what? What are you going to do? He's going to go away while he leaves all this patrolling, right? I think that's going to be it. Okay, we still have battles coming up on the side. And if Enzo wins, man, I'm going to just eat my hat. I do not have a hat, but I will go buy one and then eat it. That's what I'm going to do. But we said Kamrat has walled everything onto this area, Why did he wall this? I have no idea instead of walling this. No idea why he did that. But okay, it's fine. Kamrat is still taking attacks from Jesus on this side. Why? No idea. Max Xanatos onto his side, remaking an economy. And why is that? Because Kamrat could let him live. Why do you... Kamrat, you let Candy Cane live. You let Xanatos live, you let Enzo live, and you still don't understand that you have to kill people? Man? Sir? Person? Dong? Come on, man. Oh, look at this, we have transport ship that was ready to go to the other side to attack or something, probably. I have no idea. On this side, we still have a little bit of elephants, we got heavy scorpions, and a little bit less bomber cannons than we used to have. But now Conrad is using all his gold, and he's losing and wasting it like if it was like it was nothing. To his side, Wonder still with the countdown. Well, look, probably Enzo left with the idea that nobody will attack him or that if he no that he will not win, and when he comes back, all of this is going to be destroyed. But if this Wonder makes it with an AFK player, I don't know, man. It shouldn't happen, but it might actually happen. That is kind of a problem that we have right now. Okay, now Enzo, what is it? He's going all the way in here to attack once again, Jesus? Oh my god, Xanatos is going to come here probably to take down this wonder? Is that how it's going to be? Hopefully it's not. Look at this, all the raids that were here are now being taken by Xanatos, who's making a run of Ulsar, who is going to probably attack Kamrat as retaliation. And then Kamrat, what are you going to do? This is what happens when you don't finish your opponent. This is what happens. There's a lot of gold here. Well, not anymore, my friend. There is not going to be no more of that. There's going to be no more. Now, we have a lot of hundreds of these scavengers that are going to completely die. They're going to die to this cave scorpion. Look at them. This is just a lot. This is just too much. But still, Jesus' economy is so far away from the battleground. So, it's going to be kind of fine. So now, Xanatos can see this because the line of sight of the Hussar is just... It's enough to watch this, and with 118 HP,
They are going to survive any kind of attack that comes to him from these villagers at least. And if something else comes, I don't know what that could be. Anyways, just denying Kamrad from this gold is going to be a huge hit for his strategy. Because the only thing that he's making is the Elite Baron Elephants, he's making Bomber Cannons and Heavy Scorpions. That's the only thing that he's making. And he, if he gets prohibited of taking gold, then I think that's going to be it. That's going to be, he will have to sell wood or food. Well, he's not taking wood anywhere, right? No, I don't think so. Plus, he has made the biggest wall ever onto his side. What is this? Okay, Jesus is there. But yeah, it's going to be the biggest wall ever. But this is open. Because why wouldn't it be open? This is open. Rallying up, Cesarados, rallying up. Oh, they are allied. Okay, they are allied, apparently. Or are they not? Or they are allied for now? Maybe at this moment they are allied, but they will not be together. Heat-seeking Scorps! God damn it, X-Factor. Just imagine that. That way you cannot run unless you turn something on, like fire and stuff. Okay. Oh no, it's going to drown into the depths of the earth. Well. I have seen it all now. Now I can die. No upgrades on this Costar. No, why would you? Because it's Zaratus, man. He just plays his own game. He doesn't care. As I said before, he researched Parthian tactics like 1 hour of game time. Now why would you need a Hussar upgrade Hussar? Come on, man. You want to attack this? Of course you will need a lot of protection, a lot of attack, a lot of everything. We're talking about Zaratus. Zaratus does Zaratus stuff. So yeah, I'm pissed how they nerfed the Sound of Siege. It's also weak compared to HD. Jesus is now gone. He cannot take it anymore. Yeah, I have heard that. Exactly, I have heard that. I remember that the other day I was talking with another FIFA player, Sam Haley, and he said that he didn't want to play AoE because of the sound has been kind of nerfed, just the way you say. Is that so important? Is that really that important? Oh, it's almost silent. Well, okay. Okay, Zaratus says, okay, now what is it that you're going to do, Zaratus? Where are you going? He's going into, I don't know where. He's going to have an awesome whoosh sound. Oh. Yeah, they did. But it shouldn't be like super loud. It should be like a normal sound, because then when a lot of them are just together, then it's going to just be louder than anything else. So, it's not good, man. Zaratus, can you attack Kamrad now? Because once Kamrad loses all this food, that's going to be it, I think. Okay, man, says Zaratus. I don't know who the hell he's talking to. But okay, he's going to attack somebody. I don't know if it's going to be Enzo. But Enzo is kind of defending here with, of course, patrol stuff. Kamrad is coming in here to just take down this wonder. Will he survive? Yeah, probably he will. Because there are a lot of scorpions on the side. And there are a lot of elite battle elephants and everything. So yeah, we have a kind of a problem. So now, Electroconus attacking. We got a lot of heavy camera, because of course he's Chinese and he's going to make heavy camera. Why? No idea why, but he will anyways. He will anyways. Now what? We have a lot of heavy scorpions coming up into this area, and Mr. Zaratus is going to go into Kamrad's Cupid's base. Will he finally do something about it? Will he finally do something about it, even though there is a hole in the wall? Well, looks like he will, but why didn't he kill the units that are here? Oh, that was not him, that was Enzo's. Okay. Okay, we're about to see a massacre right now. Not only here, but here. Sorry, I have to, says Xanatos. Well then! Goodbye, man! Goodbye to everything! Goodbye to the life you already knew! Goodbye, Tokyo! Oh my god! Goodbye! Oh, look at the dead bodies, man! He just had to do it! And now to this side, we have another massacre! But this one is not as intense. No, it is more intense even. That's what I was trying to say. Than these bodies in here, that all of them hit the floor. All the bodies hit the floor. So that is a lot. That's a huge loss for a comrade. That is a huge loss. And probably some of them have now been replaced by military units. So you cannot make more of this. Of these heavy scorpions, right? At least that's what I think. At least that is what I think. On this side, we have Elite Chocolus taking down on this elite, elite battle elephants. It looks like these guys are coming to die.
Oh no, there were some queued up. Okay, there were some of these guys queued up, and the gathering point was somewhere around here. So okay, this guy was pop blocked apparently, and the gathering point was here. So that's why we have more people appearing. Even maybe some chukonu would have been a good idea as well. But this is just the way it is. Just the way it is. But yeah, an AFK player is about to win. It's not going to win though with all these heavy scorpions right here. It's not going to win. But anyways, the attack onto Comrade Scoopy is still happening. Where do we have the whoosh sound? Don't worry, X Factor. I will give you your sound. Don't worry, Shmon, you should just have a way scary sound. Let people think again when they're attacking. Yeah. Okay, there we go. There we go. They are almost about to attack. Whoosh! Right there, so you, X Factor. Whoosh, whoosh! Amazing. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. Whoosh. Well, that's it. That's all that my mouth can take. That's everything. And no, that's not what she said. Anyways, now there is no economy here. Comrade, he has some videos in here. And also, Jesus was about to attack this place. But yeah, okay, Comrade Xanatos and Enzo. Well, Comrade Xanatos are the only ones that are alive right now. But I don't know how this is going to end. There's only 165 years remaining for everything to be killed on this side. So yeah, okay, Jesus is, well, he didn't send anything really. Maybe he had some units close in here. But market going to go down, and probably if there are units in here, they are going to, if units get close, they are going to be killed by this castle, right? Yeah, they should. They have two more range than the scorpions. On the side, we got Xanatos still advancing and trying to kill an economy that doesn't exist, really. I do not see any villager right here. Any villager. Chinese with Khmer are ally are beast. More farm and one more scorp. Maybe. Anyways, what is the rest of Comrade's economy? Well, it's right here, apparently. This is his whole economy. His whole economy is right there. Comrade QP now advancing, of course, with a little bad elephants, and now it's time to get ready to take down the wonder. Man, if the wonder goes up, if the wonder goes down, if the wonder is still up after this, I don't know what I'm gonna do, really. I have no idea. Anyways, we have now more heavy comrades coming. Of course, all of them are going to die, and the wonder is going to go down as well. Should have been protected a little bit more. But yeah, that's it. Goodbye, wonder. Goodbye. Oh my god, it's gone. That is a lot of resources gone, right? Like this. Anyways, what is Comrade's economy? Is it really just this? Five villagers? I do not see anything else. Really, I do not see anything. Okay, we have this right now. And we had some villagers. Okay, we had. So, Comrade. Sorry, but I really had to take down the farms, says Xanatos. Yeah, okay, that was his whole economy, basically. Couldn't resist, says Xanatos. I understand. So, what is your wonder now? Because I believe that's the only way to win this now. We got Comrade, we got Enzo, we got Xanatos. Well, Enzo is not alive, really. He's just AFK. You think we should save chapters while playing? Is it going to affect my experience at replaying? Because when somebody leaves, it just crashes. Maybe. Let's see. Everybody will see that. I will go back to my recorded games and see if I can go to this chapter. It should be possible, right? Should be. Shall we? So, now we have a 1v1 between Comrade and Xanatos. Yeah, let's see if it works. Let's see if it works. If it works, then we might probably have the recorded games back again. You know what actually was doing it? Yeah, it's true. It is true. So, Xanatos, I believe that if there are not many units, well, except for these ones, if there are not many units, you could use spies, right, Xanatos? I think you could use spies. Hello, AOE! I mean, Malice. Yeah, I know, you were talking. Okay, you're back, okay. Now it's time for the final countdown. Well, this is probably the Eye of the Tiger or something like that. But yeah, we have a battle here. You have a lot of this mango die, a lot of camp. My God, the sound. I'm sorry. The sound is just too loud right now. I'm going to lower it a little bit. And now we're fine. I think that you guys can listen to me, and listen to the stream as well. Okay. Okay, this mango die is not coming, dying. Now they're coming and killing. Oh, look at them! This is just one shot kick. Oh, okay. It's 2-hit KO. It's kind of close. Getting in here in the middle of everything would be a good idea. We also have Six Oregon without Drill, because why would you want Drill? he has Nomads though. But yeah. How do I know that he has? No, he doesn't have Nomads because he has. Oh my God, he doesn't have Nomads. Why do we not have? Why do you not have Nomads? God damn it. Let's see this. Because we need some kind of accompaniment to this thing. Okay. So let's try this. Haha. This is the battle! Ah, okay! I cannot believe I actually did that. Okay, anyways, let's continue. We had some kind of battle right there. I hope you guys could listen to the guitar, but okay, anyway. Comrade now, with heavy scorpions, a lot of heavy scorpions. Just imagine, my God, just imagine what a heavy onager with Drill could do here. Just imagine what a heavy. Okay, do they have no Drill? Why do you not have Drill? God damn it. Okay, anyways, this Mango Day should in theory kill these heavy scorpions, right? No. They have the same range apparently. No, scorpions have better range. Okay, that's how you do it. That is how you do it. Welcome to Dead Island. Population however Xanatos wants them to have. Okay, that's all the scorpions going down one by one. All of them, one by one. One more hit! Oh, okay, well, at least he took a lot of them with just 3 onagers. Which is impressive to tell you guys the truth. It's impressive. That is a lot. And to decide, I think it would be a good idea to use this Mango Day to finish off these heavy scorpions now that they are kind of... Okay, there were some... Some of them were distracted for a moment, but now they're not. Okay, Xanatos not coming up to the side, losing a lot of Mango Day here, Elite Mango Day with everything already. Finally, they are fully upgraded. On to the side, Comrade QP making another castle without an economy. Can you believe that? This guy doesn't even have an economy, but he's still winning. I wonder how much resources did he have stockpiled. Anyways, Xanatos should see that. He should. He's not using the spice, I know, but god damn it, I just think that he should do that, really, because there is nothing that is preventing him to do it. I don't think that Comrade TP has more than the 5 villagers that were here at some point. Maybe they're moving. Okay, they're moving here. They have moved in there. And so here, and that's it. GG, says Xanatos. Okay then, alrighty then. GG. But you should take a look at the spice at the cost to see how many units, how many villagers that this guy have. And how can you kill this with a lot of siege onagers? You have this, man! Xanatos is gone! Xanatos is gone! Oh my God. Okay, now it's time for Enzo to die. Spice, it should come right now, right? It should. Now, Comrade might be the winner of the game, unless Enzo comes back in a leap of faith and somehow wins the game, which is something that is not going to happen. So Comrade says, fucking Enzo, probably. Yeah, it is, fucking Enzo. Well, Enzo, that is what Comrade thinks about you. I don't think that is really, really nice. Okay, I'm going to save chapter once again to see that moment. Okay, saving, right there, we have it. Amazing stuff. And now, Comrade, coming up onto the side. And stable, okay, it is a stable round. Okay, it is this stable, and Comrade is advancing slowly as he can, but he will try anyways. Look at these guys. Look at their hoops. They look cute. I have to say, they look cute. It's okay, and so we still not have spies unless I'm allied with them, which I'm not. Oh, and so looks at me as an ally, but Okay, probably that's why I cannot see, I didn't hear the spy stuff. Okay! Okay, I wish I could fast forward this. I wish I could. Hello, Zalatos! Did you research spies, Zalatos? I would like to know. Did you research spies? You know, in your castle, you should have put your mouse into the spy stuff, take 2 zeros out of it, put it in half, and that's the amount of villagers people have, so that would give you an idea. Why can't Ratir even have a villager, man? And you could have won this. He didn't have an economy. Okay, anyways, it's time to finish Enzo up. Of course, it's going to happen with all these elephants. I'm sorry, my hiccups is coming back again. Oh, god damn it, Xanatos. You could have used that to your advantage. You could have checked out what was the price of spice to more or less know how many villagers did these guys have. In combination, of course. But yeah, if it's less than 10k, you could say that there are only like 50 villagers somewhere around there. But it would have been a good idea, man, in my opinion. And you could have seen that this guy didn't have any kind of economy, because you destroyed his only economy. You completely destroyed it. It was nice. I know you had to do it, and it was nice to see. I was out, though. Okay, Xanatos. Okay, it's fine, don't worry. There was no more wood to take here, probably a little bit more somewhere around here. But yeah, moving up all the way up here would have been too much of a hassle. Okay, anyways, now look, yeah, you don't just need to take down these archer ranges, these stables, and these villages. And with that, I think that the pact is going to be complete. The sacrifice to the great god of Kamrat is going to be finished. I don't think that there is nothing else that you can, that Enzo has. No, there's nothing else. And there we go. That's it. That's it. Just these three buildings and these villages. That's everything we need. That's everything we need. The houses, they do not count. It's okay. Okay, now we need the villagers, and that's it. Just the villagers, man. Just the villagers. Just the villagers. And there is it. What? What is it? What is it keeping him? What is it that's keeping him alive? What could it be that is keeping him, this guy, alive? No, I don't remember his name. God damn it, I don't remember. Oh, Jesus, that was Jesus. Okay, there must be some building that can produce units somewhere. From Enzo. There must be a building that can produce stuff, because that's the only way he's alive. How? By taking down the houses? Oh, there was a villager. Okay, that was it. Okay, there was a villager. Okay, I was like, god damn it. Okay, anyways, good game, Kamrat. You win! And let's check out the statistics right now. Military-wise, we got almost 2k units killed by Kamrat. And what happened with your economy, Kamrat? Business rates also, Kamrat. And the one who lost the most was actually Jesus. And the one who lost more buildings was Enzo. Units converted, won by Enzo. And Lurgus Army, 227. Economy-wise, you can see that food is now... God damn it, is that 145k? Yeah, it is! Wow, that is a lot. And also gold, 150k. Wood collected, 80k. And stone collected, almost 10k. Just 12 away from it by... It was no Xanatos, return to map. It was purple. Okay, it was Candy Cane. Okay, good. It was Candy Cane. And then to technology, you can see the first one advancing to the field was Kamrat, the first one to the castle was Candy Cane, and the first one to the Imperial was Jesus. Percentage of the map explored by Kamrat, 72%, and research count for Jesus, 59 society wide. You can see that 1 wonder for Enzo, 10 castles for both Enzo and the Xanatos. And Rally's captured 4 by Xanatos, that gave him in the end a lot of gold. Almost as much as Enzo, though. Almost as much. Villager hike 197 for Candy Cane. And here you can see the timeline, how Enzo gets completely destroyed at some point, and then he's left with a little bit, and then destroyed once again. Good game by Kamrat!